the cult of personality. I know you're in ya. I never intended to include Chris Brown's name in one of my tweets to start some sort of a controversy or to gain publicity or anything like that. And now that he's thrown accusations my way about using steroids, I feel the need to reply. So please allow me to retort. I'm a lifelong, proud, drug-free, straight-edge individual. So Chris and I come from two completely different worlds. I don't have a manager. I don't have a bodyguard. I don't need a bodyguard. I don't have an assistant. I have no need for a PR team to tell me what to tweet or when to delete tweets. And I don't hate women. See, period. You don't hate women. In my world, women are to be revered and respected. And I firmly believe that in this life, there are consequences and repercussions for people's actions. And I don't think Chris is paid for what he's done. And picking up trash on the side of a highway does not make amends for repeatedly striking a woman in her face and sending her to a hospital. So Chris wants to throw stones my way now. And I say, that's fine, but put some gloves on and get in the ring. And I will choke you out, and I will make you feel as weak and as powerless and scared and alone as any woman who has had the misfortune of knowing a sad, cowardly little boy such as yourself. And all proceeds can go to a women's shelter of my choosing. If you want to pick up more trash on the side of the highway to make some amends, you should donate some more time. Maybe tell kids that exactly what you did isn't right. But I'm also a realist, and I know that none of these things will happen because Chris Brown isn't a man. And that's fine. I just know that someday, somewhere, somehow, somebody will put Chris Brown exactly where he belongs, and it honestly doesn't have to be me. I would just really like it to be.